classroom. I'm your English teacher, Sheikh Rafi. Today, in this video, I'm going to start the very first unit from your textbook. Dear students, the theme of this unit is personality development. If you look at your textbook, the theme sheet of this unit, you will find that there are three readings given in this unit. A reading, attitude is altitude. B reading, every success story is also a story of great failures. And C reading, I will do it. So, dear students, let us start this unit first of all by understanding the theme of this unit. The theme is personality development. Personality refers to the qualities of a person. Every person has certain qualities. Qualities are also called features or characteristics. A person may have good qualities or he may have bad qualities. Qualities can be visible externally or it can be internal qualities also. For example, when we see cine actors, we feel that they are all great personalities because we look at their external qualities. That is their physique, their looks, their acting, their dancing, etc. But for example, when we look at leaders, what we look at? We look at their internal qualities. That is the way they think, the way they serve the country, etc. So those qualities are internal qualities. So when we say personality, it refers to both internal qualities as well as external qualities of a person. Now, what do you mean by development? Development is a very common word. Development means progress or growth. So when we say personality development, it means growing our personality. Now, immediately we may have a doubt. How can we grow our personality? Very easy, students. Personality can be grown by giving away bad qualities and acquiring good qualities. Hey, come on, once again, how do we develop our personalities? By giving away bad qualities and acquiring good qualities. So with that background, let us start the very first unit for you, personality development. I want all of you to look at page number 2, the face sheet of this unit. You are going to find the pictures of three great personalities given there. Even their names are mentioned. Sudha Chandran, the second one is Stephen Hawking, and the third one is Helen Keller. Before going further, let us know a little bit about these three personalities. Sudha Chandran is a very famous Indian classical dancer. She has acted in many films as well as in TV serials. Coming to Stephen Hawking, he is a world famous scientist, a physicist who has done lot of work in the area of black holes. And the third person is Helen Keller. Helen Keller is a world famous humanitarian and a novelist from America. So see, some questions are given there under the pictures. First question, what qualities have made these persons great? Now, to know these qualities, we should first know a little bit about their background. See, there is one common thing among all the three peoples. They are very famous, very great personalities, but all of them are physically challenged. Sudha Chandran, for example, when she was very young, she met with a road accident and lost one of her legs. Can you imagine a dancer without a leg? Is it possible? No, for a dancer, legs are very, very important. But she lost one of her leg in a road accident. Coming to Stephen Hawking, he is a world famous scientist. You know, when he was very young, he got a disease called motor neuron disease. And because of that, his entire body was paralyzed and he was confined to a wheelchair. He cannot move any part of his body. Only active part in his body is his mind. The third person, Helen Keller, a world famous humanitarian as well as a novelist from America. She is deaf and blind right from her childhood. Right? So these are the disabilities in these people, but they became great in spite of these disabilities. So the first question is, what qualities have made these persons great? The basic or the most important quality that they had was they all had positive attitude. Though they were physically challenged, they never lost hope in life. They struggled, they worked hard, and they became successful in their life. See the second question. What qualities do you think a person requires to become successful? Oh, to becoming successful, one needs lots and lots and lots of qualities, right? First thing, we should have a desire to achieve success in life. We should have motivation. We should have energy. We should do hard work. We should be sincere, loyal, dedication, determination, discipline. These are some of the qualities which are definitely needed by a person to become successful. Children, today we are going to start the very first lesson, A reading, Attitude is Altitude. I'm telling you, the first unit in your entire textbook is a wonderful unit which gives you lessons for life. And if you go through these lessons thoroughly, I'm very sure that each one of you will get something from this lesson, right? The name of the first lesson is Attitude is Altitude. Now, what do you mean by attitude? Attitude means way of thinking. Way of thinking. Whereas, altitude means heights. So overall, when you look at the name of the lesson, we understand that the way you think is going to decide the heights you are going to reach in your life. Wow, that's a beautiful concept. The way you think is going to decide the heights you are going to reach in your life. Now, what do you mean by way of thinking? I'll give you one very beautiful example which once a teacher asked in a class. The teacher showed to the entire class a glass which was half filled and asked the students, "What do you see in it?" One of the students said, "Sir, the glass is half empty." Another student said, "Sir, the glass is half full." Now, when you look at these answers, both of them are correct. Both the answers are correct. But the only thing is in the difference of the attitude of the students. The one who said it is half empty, he is looking at what is not there. So that is a negative attitude. But the student who says it is half full, we call him with positive attitude because he is looking at what is there. Now, this is the attitude that we need to develop. Right, children? So with that background, let us start the first lesson. Attitude is altitude. Now, this is a lesson about a physically handicapped person. His name is Nick Vujicic. Nick Vujicic, he is physically challenged. He doesn't have arms and legs. Though he doesn't have arms and legs, but today he is a world famous personality. He is a motivational speaker who has given motivation to millions and millions of people. Children, let us learn about his life and let we also be motivated from his life. I want all of you to look at page number 3, the top of the lesson, A reading, Attitude is Altitude. Imagine having no arms to stretch in the morning, to help you scratch that itch, to allow you to wrap your arms around your loved ones. Imagine having no legs to kick pebbles down the street, to walk or run, to bicycle or skateboard, or get you from point A to point B. Then imagine both at once, which is what Nick Vujicic has faced his whole life. Have you heard something like this before? Now, in this very first paragraph, the author is asking you to imagine. First, he asks you to imagine having no arms. Without hands, we can't do anything. For each and everything, for picking up things, for writing, reading, etc., we use our hands. And author says, imagine having no arms. Without arms, we can't even scratch an itch on our body. Without arms, how can we wrap our loved ones? Without arms, how can we stretch it? We can't do anything without arms. Similarly, the second thing, the author asks you to imagine having no legs. My God, very, very horrible situation. Imagine having no legs. Without legs, we cannot move from one place to another place. We cannot walk, we cannot run, we cannot bicycle, we cannot skateboard, we cannot play. We cannot move from any place to any other place. And finally, the third thing the author asks you is to imagine both at once. That is having no arms and having no legs. Now, this imagination is horrible, horrible. We can't imagine. Now, this is what is the life of Nik Vujicic, who is the main character in this story. Now, author asks you, have you ever seen any such case? Maybe you would have seen a person without one hand or both the hands, or without a leg or two legs, but without both arms and both legs, it is very rare. So let us see the life of Nik Vujicic. Nik Vujicic was born with no arms and legs, but he doesn't let the details stop him. The brave 26 years old, who is mainly a torso, plays football and golf, swims and surfs, despite having no limbs. Now that is the life of Nik Vujicic. How is he? He was born without arms and legs. See the next sentence, it's a very important sentence. I want all of you to underline it. He doesn't let the details stop him. He refers to Nik Vujicic. What are the details of Nik? He doesn't have arms and legs. He doesn't let the details stop him. These details, that is not having arms and legs, it doesn't stop him from coming up in his life. The brave 26 years old, he is mainly a torso. What is torso? Torso refers to the main part of the body, the trunk and the head. And what does he do? He plays football and golf, swim, surf, despite having no limbs. Ah, how is it possible? Can a man play football without foot? Can we swim without arms? Let us see how Nik does this thing. See the next paragraph. Nik has a small foot on his left hip, which helps him balance and enables him to kick. He uses his one foot to type, write with a pen, and pick up things with his toes. Now that is the details of his rest of the body. What does the author says? He has a small foot on his left hip. If you see the picture given there in the textbook, where he is swimming, at the bottom of his left hip, you can notice a small foot there. So what he says, he uses his one foot to type, to write with the pen, and to pick up things between his toes. See the next para. I call it my chicken drumsticks, joked Nik. Nik is joking about his one small foot. What he calls it? He says, I call it my chicken drumstick. Now, what is chicken drumstick? You know, every Sunday your mother cooks it. Everyone loves chicken. Fry leg piece, right? So what he says, I call it my chicken drumstick, joked Nik, who was born in Melbourne, Australia, but now lives in Los Angeles. I would be lost without it. Nik says, I would be lost without it. It refers to the small foot on his left hip. Though he jokes, he calls his small foot as a chicken drumstick. But he is not really joking. He is very serious about it. Why? Because he feels he would be lost without it. See the next para. Water sports aren't Nick's only thing. He also plays golf with a club tucked under his chin and is a huge fan of the English Premier League. So we are further introduced to the life of Nik, right? Instead of water sports, there are a number of things which he likes. He also plays golf. How he plays golf? We generally, when we play golf, we hold the club with our hands. But Nik, he keeps it. He tucks it under his chin and plays it. He's a huge fan of English Premier League. Like in India, we have IPL, Indian Premier League, which is a cricket series. Similarly, in Western countries, we have English Premier League, which is a football match series. See the next para. His parents decided not to send him to a special school, a decision, he said, was very hard for him, but which may have been the best decision they could have made for him. Now see here, we are introduced to his parents. At the very beginning, his parents decided not to send him to a special school. Now, what is a special school and what is a normal school? Special schools are those schools which are meant for physically challenged people. For example, we have separate schools for blind children. We have separate schools for physically handicapped children. We have separate schools for mentally handicapped children. So for all abnormal children, we have separate schools. They are called special schools. And what are normal schools? The place where you are all studying, they are all normal schools because, normal children come and study there. How is Nick? Nick is a physically challenged boy. So he should have been sent to a special school. But his parents decided not to send him to a special school, but they sent him to a normal school, which we call mainstream school. And Nick, at the beginning, he didn't like this decision. He felt that his parents' decision was very hard. But later on, he said that was the best decision his parents took for him. Now, how it was best, we are going to see in the further paragraphs. Let us see the next paragraph. When Nick was born, his father was so shocked that he left the hospital room to vomit. His distraught mother couldn't bring herself to hold him until he was 4 months old. Now in this paragraph, we are introduced to the reaction of his parents when he was born. Children, generally when somebody is born in a family, it is like a festival for everyone. We inform each and every relative, we inform each and every friend, we distribute sweets, we organize parties, etc. You know, everyone is happy. They celebrate the birth in a family. But in case of Nick, it was totally opposite. His father was so shocked that he left the hospital room to vomit. He couldn't see a child like that. And what was the mother's reaction? She was distraught. What do you mean by distraught? You know, greatly saddened. She was so sad that she couldn't bring herself to hold the baby until he was 4 months old. Now that was how his parents reacted. Let us see further in the next paragraph. His disability came without any medical explanation, a rare occurrence called phocomelia. And Nick and his parents spent many years asking why this cruel trick would happen to them. My mother was a nurse and she did everything right during pregnancy, but she still blamed herself, he said. So Nick tells, they couldn't understand why this thing happened to Nick. They asked the doctors. And what did the doctors tell him? They said it is a rare occurrence. This type of disease is called phocomelia. And what did they do? They couldn't do anything. Nick and his parents spent a lot of years to study why this cruel trick happened to that. What is the cruel trick here? Nick being born without arms and legs. So why this thing happened to them? They tried to study for a long time, but nobody could understand. Nick's mother was a nurse. So she took all precautions that should be taken when somebody is pregnant. But still, she blamed herself. She blamed herself. Maybe she did something wrong for which Nick was like that. So that is how the reaction of the parents was there. So let us see further. It was so hard for them, but right from the start, they did their best to make me independent. Now, the only challenge before the parents of Nick was to make Nick independent. So what they did? My dad put me in the water at 18 months and gave the courage to learn how to swim. I also got really good into football and skateboarding. I totally love the English Premier League. Nick's father was a computer programmer and accountant, and he taught his little son how to type with his toe at just 6 years old. His mom invented a special plastic device that meant he could hold a pen or a pencil. Now that is what is going on. Nick and his parents decided that they are going to make Nick independent. Nick should be able to do his works on his own. So what they do? Their parents started giving him training. When Nick was 18 years old, they put him in water and taught him how to swim. Now children, you can do an introspection yourself. How many of you know swimming? I am sure half of you don't know how to swim. It's a basic life skill. All of you must learn it. Right? So at a very early age, when Nick was only 18 months old, his father taught him how to swim. His father was a computer programmer. So he taught other things like typing, etc. with his toes. And his mom, she invented a special device with which he can hold a pen or pencil to write. So his training started. Despite the risk of being bullied, his parents insisted on his attending mainstream school. "It was the best decision they could have made for me," adds Nick, who later achieved a degree in financial planning and real estate. "It was very hard, but it gave me independence." So Nick says, despite the risk of being bullied, his parents decided to send him to mainstream school. That is what we learned in the previous paragraph. His parents decided to send him to a mainstream school. There was a risk of being bullied. What is being bullied? You know, children, when we go to school, we find in many school, right, children who are weak, they are teased, they are threatened, they are beaten by children who are strong. That behavior is called bullied. And how was Nick? Nick couldn't move at all. He was totally dependent on others. Can you imagine such a student can stay safe in a mainstream school? So that is why he felt that the decision what his parents had taken was not good for him. But somehow he went to the school and he successfully completed his education. He got a degree in financial planning and real estate, which made him really independent. That is why he says later on, he felt that was the best decision his parents had taken. Okay, let us see the next paragraph. Nick, who was teased and bullied, had an electric wheelchair for mobility and a team of carers to help him. See the next para. "I was deeply depressed when I was 8 years old," he said. "I went to my mom crying and told her I wanted to kill myself. I felt cold and bitter. I hated God for doing this to me and was terrified of what would happen when my parents weren't there to look after me." So here we understand the depression of Nick. And what did Nick do? When he was 8 years old, he went to his mom and told her, "I want to kill myself." Can you imagine this situation? How would his mom would have felt when she heard that his son wants to kill himself? No? So what happened? Why? "I felt cold and bitter." Cold and bitter means he disliked the situation. He was so sad. He hated God. Why he hated God? For doing this to me. What has God done to him? God had given him birth without arms and legs. So he says, "I hated God for doing this to me and was terrified of what would happen to him after his parents weren't there." Now that's a very, very difficult situation. What he says further, see, "I could brush my own teeth with a wall-mounted brush and wash my own hair with a pump-action soap, but there was so much that was impossible for me." Though Nick was independent in many things, but still there were lots and lots of things which Nick could not do on his own. He can brush his teeth with a wall-mounted brush. Brush is fixed on the wall and he has to take his mouth close to it. He can wash his hairs with a pump suction method, but there were many, many things which he couldn't do on his own. So he was just worried, what will happen when my parents weren't there to help me all these things. At age 10, Nick tried to drown himself in the bath, but luckily the attempt was unsuccessful. Now see the level of depression. He went in such a depression that he tried to commit suicide. How? By trying to drown himself in the water tub. I felt there was no purpose when you lack purpose and strength. It's a beautiful statement. I felt there was no purpose if you lack purpose and strength in life. Purpose here refers to aim. If you don't have aim in your life, then there is no purpose of your life. This is what Nick felt. It is hard to hold on. It is hard to hold on means it is difficult to survive, he said. But with the help of his religion, friends and family, Nick managed to pull through to become an international symbol of triumph over adversity. Now that is the change which is going to come in Nick. How he became an international symbol of victory or triumph over adversity? With the help of his religion, family and friends. Now how this change came in Nick, this is what we are going to see in our next paragraph. So let us continue. When I was 13, I read a newspaper article about a disabled man who had managed to achieve great things and helped others, said Nick. So this is what happened. I realized why God had made us like this, to give hope to others. Now that's a very important change that is coming in Nick's life. What happened one day when he was 13 years old? He read a newspaper article about another disabled person. Now that article gave him lot of courage, right? He got inspired from the article, and that disabled man, he had achieved great success in his life and he had also helped others. So from that article, Nick got lot of inspiration and he realized why God has made him like this. Why? To give hope to others. There are many people in this world who have become hopeless, who are ready to die, who are ready to commit suicide, who are ready to end up their life because they are so troubled in their life. And Nick will give them hope. Nick will give them hope. It was so inspirational to me that I decided to use my life to encourage other people and give them the courage that the article had given me. Now see, that's an important change coming in Nick's life. He got so motivated. He understood the purpose of his life. Why God has made him like that. Why? Just because to give hope to others. Hope to others, the way the article had given him the hope. So he decided he will do that. See there, next parable. I decided to be thankful for what I do have and not get angry about what I don't. Now that's a beautiful statement, children. I want all of you to underline it in your textbook. Very, very important statement. What he says, I decided to be thankful for what I have. I decided to be thankful for what I have and not get angry about what I don't. This is what the biggest mistake most of the people do. We always keep on crying for those things which we don't have. And in this process, what do? We lose those things which we have. Right? This is a very, very wrong attitude. Now, this is what the attitude that you have to learn from this chapter. Be thankful for what you have. Be thankful. Stand in front of a mirror. Look at yourself. God has blessed you with everything. You have each and every part of your body intact. What else you need? You are not like Nick. We should be thankful to the God for whatever He has given to us. Generally, students, this is the attitude of each and every person. We always keep on blaming. Suppose your parents ask you to study, we'll complain. We'll say, Dad, I don't have a book, I don't have a pen or pencil, or I don't have a good atmosphere, I don't have a table, I don't have a computer, etc. What is needed for studying is a determination. Instead of having that, we always complain of what we don't have. So this attitude must be changed. We should never complain about those things which we don't have. Instead, we should thank the God for what God has given to us. Now, this is a very, very important change in Nick's life. I hope you will also bring the same change in your life. So what he says, I decided to be thankful for what I do have and not get angry about what I don't. I looked at myself in the mirror and said, you know what the world is right, that I have no arms and legs, but they will never take away the beauty of my eyes. I wanted to concentrate on something good that I had. So that is how it changed. He accepts that God hasn't given him hands and legs, but God has given him eyes. Nobody can take away the beauty of his eyes. So he decided to concentrate on the good which he has. So that is how the attitude of Nick changed. Let us see the next paragraph. The challenges in our lives are there to strengthen our convictions. They are not there to run us over. Very beautiful statement, students. I want all of you to underline that thing. The challenges in our lives, challenges means problems. Every one of us is bound to face problems, challenges in our life. But what should we do? The challenges are there to strengthen our conviction. Conviction means belief. The more and more the problems you face, the more and more experienced you become, and the more and more you are strengthened. So challenges are good for us. They strengthen our belief. They are not there to run us over. So challenges are not there to crush us. They are not there to crush us, or they are not there to run us over. So we should all bear in it mind. If God gives you any challenge, you should be happy. God has given you a chance to prove yourself, to strengthen yourself. See further. In 1990, Nick won the Australian Young Citizen of the Year Award for his bravery and perseverance. So, see the change. Nick got Young Australian Citizen Award, and this award was given for his bravery and perseverance. What is perseverance? The quality of determination. We try again and again and again. We never give up. That attitude is called perseverance. See another beautiful incident from Nick's life. And once I was in a car and a girl at traffic lights was looking at me interestingly. She could only see my head. So I decided to do a 360 degree spin in the car seat to freak her out. Her face was like, "Ooh, what is going on?" She sped off really quickly. Now we get a very funny incident here from Nick's life. Once Nick was going in a car and his car stopped at a traffic light. You know what happened there? One more car came and stood next to him. And in that car, there was a girl who was looking at Nick interestingly. Now that girl could see only Nick's head. So that is why she was looking interestingly. So what did Nick do? Nick decided to freak her out, to frighten her. So what did he do? He gave a 360 degree turn. So he took his head down and rest of the body up. The moment the girl saw this, she was absolutely frightened and she sped away really quickly from there. Nick began traveling the world in 2008. He went to Hawaii and met surfing master Bethany Hamilton, who had her arm bitten off by a shark when she was 12. So in 2008, it so happened that Nick went on traveling and he went to Hawaii Islands where he wanted to learn surfing. Now surfing is an adventure sports. It's a game of surfing on the waves of ocean. So he went and he met the surfing master there. Her name was Bethany Hamilton. Now even she was special. How? Because at the age of 12, she had got one of her arm bitten by a shark. Now see what Nick says about her. See the next para. She was amazing, said Nick. She taught me how to surf and I was terrified at first. But once I got up there, it felt absolutely fantastic and I caught some of waves pretty well. Nick quickly learned how to do a 360 degree spin on his board, a feat that got him onto the cover of Surfer magazine within 48 hours. No one has ever done that in the history of surfing, he said. But I have a very low center of gravity, so I have got pretty good balance. Now, this is how the thing started. When Nick started learning surfing, at the beginning, he was terrified. He was absolutely afraid. But later on, slowly, he learned and he became very successful. And he also learned how to do a 360 degree spin on the waves. Now, that's really a feast. Now, this is a great thing which he was able to do because this helped him coming into the magazine cover and he became very famous. And why he could do all these things? Because he had very low center of gravity compared with a normal person. He has visited different countries all over the world. The football fan is now a motivational speaker and has traveled to over 24 countries speaking to groups of up to 110,000 people. Now, that is what is Nick's life. If you remember when he was a kid, he tried to commit suicide. He wanted to end up his life. But today, Nick is one of the world famous motivational speaker. He is, a highly successful person. Let us see further about Nick's life. He moved to Los Angeles in 2007 and planned to continue to travel the world. In 2009, he visited South America and the Middle East. In 2008, Kane Mihara, a beautiful young girl whose mother was a Mexican and whose father was a Japanese, attended to a meeting where Nick was the guest speaker in Texas. Kane was attracted to Nick's message. Now here we find another interesting character entering into the stories. What is her name? Kane Mihara, a beautiful young girl whose mother was a Mexican and whose father was a Japanese. Now this girl had the same interest like Nick. So she used to attend almost all meetings of the Nick. She got attracted to Nick, to his messages. Let us see what happens further. From that time, they were in touch with each other to share their ideas on giving hope to the needy and they become close friends. So we can see here, since both of them had same ideas, same thoughts, they became very close friends. Finally, they fell in love and their engagement happened in August 2011. Nick put the engagement ring on Kane's finger with his mouth and then said the most beautiful words every girl wants to hear coming out from her man's mouth. Baby, I love you. Now, children, you can see the change in Nick's life going on. Once upon a time, there was a time when Nick wanted to kill himself. He wanted to commit suicide. He wanted to end his life. Now we see how his life has changed. He has become a successful person and he got a woman even to get married. So let us see further what happens. Nick and Kane got married on February 12th, 2012. And on February 13th, 2013, they were blessed with the birth of a healthy baby boy with full body. So we can see Nick got a baby with full body. So that was a rare occurrence. Once in, millions it happens that a child is born without arms and legs. So that happened with Nick, but not with his son. Nick and Kane wrote an inspirational book, Love Without Limits, together, and it was published in 2014. Now, the last paragraph which gives you the entire message of his life. What he says, if I fail, I try again and again and again. If you fail, are you going to try again? The human spirit can handle much worse than we realize. It matters how you are going to finish. Are you going to finish strong? Nick said. Now that is the gist of the Nick's message. What Nick says, everybody is bound to face problems in his life. But if you fail in your life, what are you going to do? Nick says, if I fail, I try again and again and again. Nick says, human spirit, human soul, humans can handle much worse than this. We can bear any amount of pain. We can bear any amount of adversities. That much of spirit is there with humans. We can handle that much of things. And he says, it matters how you are going to finish. How we started, it doesn't matter. What is important is how you are going to end. And he asks you a final question. Are you going to end strong? That is what we have to remember in our life. How we are born, where we are born, all these things are matters of fate. God decides that thing. But once the life is in your hands, it is all up to you how you make it life, how you are making your life. So how are you going to end up? Are you going to end strong? That is the question, he says. I tell people to keep on getting up when they fall and to always love themselves, he said. If I can encourage just one person, then my job in this life is done. That is the thing what Nick says. If I keep on telling people to get up when they fall. And he also tells us, love yourself. We should love ourselves. Children, growth begins when you start loving yourself. Always look at you positively. Don't make yourself timid. Don't make yourself belittled. Always think good of you. Always think good of you, because you are the only and one of your type. There is none like yours. God has created you. You are the creation of the God, and you should always remember the thing. And what he further said, if I can encourage just one person, then my job in this life is done. Nick has encouraged millions of people. Nick has encouraged millions of people. Now, this is how the lesson ends. Lots and lots of things that we can learn from the life of Nick. Right, children? God has blessed us with everything. We have got good body, good physique, good mind. All our parts are active. We should be thankful to God for whatever he has given us. We should not blame others. We should not blame, or we should not cry over those things which we don't have. Let us be happy with what we have. Let us thank the God. And always remember, challenges are there in our life to strengthen our convictions. Challenges are there in our life to strengthen our convictions, to strengthen our beliefs. The more and more you face challenges in your life, the more and more you become strengthened. Always bear in mind, the more and more you become strengthened in your life. Don't get run over by challenges. Don't get run over by challenges. Start loving yourself. We are bound to fail. Nobody succeeds in life at the very first attempt. We have to try again and again and again until we succeed. Always bear in mind, human spirit can handle much worse than we imagine. I hope all of you understand this lesson. That was all about attitude is altitude. I hope all of you enjoyed this really motivating lesson and got benefited from it. Children, this was the first part of my video where I brought you the very first lesson. In my second part, I will get you with the glossary, that is vocabulary and grammar exercise. Till that time, have a good time. Thank you very much for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.